Hi everyone, thanks to come to this presentation. My name is Balazs Varga and I'm working for Allotropia. In this presentation I would like to talk about some Calc improvements in this year, and I also want to like to introduce and showing a little demo how the accessibility sidebar have been improved in the last few months. So let's get started. On this first slide you can see a problem related to Calc comments. When we hide a column, row or cell, the comment didn't disappear. Of course, in this screenshot, the note should not disappear because there is no hidden row, column or cell at all. This is the previous, how it looked like. And let's see the result. On the left side, you can see the result on an older LibreOffice version where the comments are didn't disappear when we filtered out the row. On the right side, you can see the results after fixing the issue and the comments are hidden. It's also working if you just hide a cell, a column or row or anything else. Comments will also be hidden. Okay, let's see the next one. This is on this slide. You can also see an improvement in the fix related to Calc comments. The goal was to show the author name and the create or modification date of a comment. It was quite complicated because during code review we decided to not change the visible comments. The reason is that the comment box often need to be resized to fit the author and time metadata, but permanently visible comments are really part of the document layout as they can be precisely resized and moved around, and we don't want to break the layout of existing documents. The other alternative is to append the metadata to the comment contents as editable text like Excel does, but this would only work only for new comments. The third option might be to have a dedicated sidebar view of comments and show the metadata there instead of in the document area, but that was a way out of the scope in this case of fix. So as you know, we have two different status of the comments, so we only can show the author name and the creation or modification date of a comment in the temporary mode. In edit mode we cannot show that, we only show the content of the comment. But if anyone has modified a comment or create a new comment, or we import a document or ODF or OXML, it will show in temporary mode the original creator name and the date as well, because this two format contains these datas. And also the export works as well. Let's see the next issue in this case. The cell validity didn't accept any formulas in the cell and we got an error message. So as you can see, so first of all we had to solve this problem, first of all we had to calculate the result from the formula, then we had to check that the result is valid for the cell and is acceptable after we set the validation for the cell. You can see on the left side it was wrong, but on the right side you can see it's working now, working with all kind of functions. In the example there is a today function, and in the validation window I don't know that it's seeable because it's very light, but there is no error message there. Okay, the next fix was just a smaller issue. In case of Calc, the hyperlink wasn't stand out well, like in Writer. where the hyperlink have color and underline attribute as well, but in Calc the hyperlink no underline attribute, only the color attribute. So I had to extend it, and the result is maybe it's seeable on the right side, that there is an underline. And of course, it's not a direct format on the text, but it's an already set attribute for the hyperlinks. Okay, the next one is related to VBA macros. The export as fixed format VBA function, which as you can see on the left side of the screenshot, didn't work earlier, and we got an error message with the basic runtime error, the property or method not found. This export as fixed format function is used for the PDF export, and now it works with worksheet and workbook objects as well. With the workbook VBA object, you can export all the worksheets, and the worksheet object you can choose which worksheet you want to export to PDF. Also, there are attributes related to this VBA function, like the type, file name, the quality of the PDF export, or include document properties. You can set that you want to export with that or without that. Also, you can set that you want to ignore the print areas in the function attribute with the true or false. And also, you can set that you want to open the document after you exported or published into PDF, which I think all the attributes except the ignore print areas is not working at the moment, but all the others you can set. And it's working also the import and export as well. The next one, on the left side you can see that the XLFX file with the SHA384 encryption didn't work. You can see on the left side, in different versions there were different problems. I mean the older versions, the file was corrupted or opened with decrypted data. So you can just saw many stupid things there. On the right side, you can see how we can open this kind of encrypted file without any problems. So the password pop-up window will pop up. You can type the password and it will open perfectly. And also the import and the also export works as well. Okay, let's the next one is related to Writer. It was a smaller improvement. In this case, we have a hidden section between two paragraphs, and if we accidentally delete the hidden section between two other paragraphs in the file, the hidden section will also be deleted without any notification. Maybe because we didn't remember that there was some kind of hidden section. So in the earlier versions it was deleted, but in the newer version we have a confirm dialog, as you can see on the right side, and you can choose you want to delete or not. If you select that you don't want to delete the hidden section, only the other selected paragraphs will be deleted, but the hidden section will stay at the original place and will be not deleted. If you select yes, of course everything will be deleted, also the hidden section. The next one was UI improvements. In this case, the menus with submenus was always enabled, even if all the submenus were enabled. An example is, for example, the table menus in Writer. The table insert menu or the table Delete menus are always active, even if we cannot insert row or columns at all. That's also true for a lot of other menu items in the LibreOffice. The plan was, if all the submenus are disabled, let's disable the upper level menu as well. Also, it was an accessibility problem as well, because accessibility tools should skip those menus which are not available. So let's see how it looks like now. Okay, I'm not sure that it's seeable, but on the left side you can see in the older version there are three levels of the menus, and all the submenus are enabled on the third level, but the upper levels are not disabled. So in this context, all the second level should be disabled, and because of that, the top level menu should be also disabled. On the right side, you can see there is no option to select the first level, but on the left side, you can select all these menus. It's also important because I think we have a setting flag for that, so we can hide all the disabled menus in LibreOffice. So if you set that true in the options, all these menus will disappear as well. This is another example with the table insert and the table delete menus, which are also enabled now on the UI, and also the sub menus as well. Okay, let's move on to another part of this presentation. At Allotropia, I also worked on the accessibility check sidebar and the automatic accessibility checking. As you can see in the meta bag, a lot of issues have been closed. So I will show a little demo or how it looks like now, how it works, what we can complain about on the sidebar. Just some notes here that the concept of accessible design and practice accessible development ensure both direct access and indirect access, meaning compatibility with a person's associative technology, for example, computer screen readers. And also, the automatic accessibility check is also necessary for the PDF UA and PDF accessibility checkers as well. Just a short note, and I will show it later, that we have document level accessibility checks, like document default language is not set, or document title is not set on the document, or we have missing alternative and description text checkers for objects, and we have formatting related accessibility checkers, hyperlink, simulated captions, and a lot of others. So in this conference, of course, there were other presentations about the accessibility issue, which you may could be important also to check that with, I think, Michael Wickhorn already talked, and Mihai Steil as well. And Samuel will talk a bit later, and he will also show some accessibility sidebar improvements. So, this is an example document. Oh, you cannot see it. Oh, now it's working, I guess. So this is an example document with a lot of accessibility issue. As I mentioned, there are document level accessibility issues. There are two examples for that here. For example, the document default language is not set. We already have now this kind of fix button. So if you click on the fix button, for example, in case of document default language is not set, it will go to you to these options directly to the options where you can set it and fix this issue. So if I choose a language and click apply, then this accessibility warning should have disappeared. As you can see, there is not there anymore. That's also true for the document title is not set, where you can set some kind of document title. And if you set that, that warning will also disappear. There were a lot of problems around updating these issues. In the code base, there were a bunch of fixes for updating properly, because updating these warnings is related to the nodes inside the document. So if something is modified in the content node, we will also check the number of the accessibility issues. On the sidebar, you can also see some missing alternative and description text, which is also important for the screen reading applications, which will read, for example, if we have no name of or description of an image or any kind of objects, this screen reader application cannot read loudly. So for that, we have these kind of warnings, for example, pictures. So you can also fix these issues and directly the description windows will pop up, and you can, of course, type something here. And if you fix the issue, it should also disappear. And also, the object will be selected in the document as well, which is also useful. And it's also true for any kind of shapes, images, and text frames as well, because you can set them any kind of description or content. So you can fix these issues with the fix button. Also, if you type something into the description, it will disappear after you fix the issue. There are also some formatting problems in the document. You can double click on these kind of accessibility warnings, and it will select the exact text in the document, and you can remove the formats. In this case, this is an example for the text formatting conveys additional meanings, which means we have extra direct format on the paragraphs, for example, on this. And if I clear direct formatting, it disappeared from the list. So there are also two remaining warning for this direct format in the document. We also have another warnings, of course. For example, avoid new lines to create space, which is important because a lot of people put a lot of empty paragraphs into the document just to make some space, extra space. With that, we can also jump into the document to clicking on the link on the accessibility sidebar, and we can just delete it. Also, we have hyperlink related issues. For example, the hyperlink text is too short. It's not selected. Yeah, if you double click on that, we also select the link in the document and we can edit that. Or the hyperlink text is the same as the link address. We also have a warning for that. So if you're clicking on that, it will be selected and you can fix those issues. Also, there are a lot of other accessibility warnings, for example, avoid footnotes in the document. It is important because the screen readers cannot read these kind of things in the document. I just lost a lot of things here in the document. So, and we have a lot of another warnings into the document, which was mostly there were problems, as I mentioned, around updating the issue, or we didn't jump into a direct place into the document, or just completely missed in the accessibility sidebar. So, I think nothing have left. Yeah, just thanks to our customers to founding the work around accessibility issues, and time for questions.
Brilliant, 20 minutes slot for this. This talk was 20 minutes scheduled. So. But if you have any questions, Simon has prepared any questions for Balazs?
Nicely done.
Yeah.
Oh, thank you.
Okay, thanks, Balazs.
Thank you.